The reason I'm selling is after 4 years here, my HOA fees have almost doubled.
In 2000, Jim's HOA fee was about $345 a month, and now it's nearly doubled. He's paying over $600 a month. And Jim's not alone. We're getting a lot of calls right now from people who are at a point where they can barely afford to pay these high HOA fees, and they have no choice but to sell.
I'll miss Boca, one of the sweetest spots in Florida. A lot of activity, a lot of action.
There are three key drivers skyrocketing HOA fees. The biggest driver is insurance. Homeowners insurance across Florida increased a daunting 40% in 2023. Most people blame rising insurance costs on hurricane claims. Between 2017 and 2021, Florida insurers paid out a staggering $51 billion. And you would think that most of that money went to hurricane victims, but 71% of the $51 billion went towards attorney fees and public adjusters, while only 8% was allocated to claimants. That's insane. The large payout complexity in the law drove about 30 insurance carriers like Bankers, AIG, and Farmers right out of the state. There's good news on the horizon though. Last year, Florida legislation implemented massive changes to the way claims are processed. They also eliminated provisions such as one-way attorney fees and assignment of benefits. These changes are starting to work. For example, six new property insurance companies have entered the Florida market. CEO of Premier Protection Insurance, Jerry Katz, explains there's some other good news regarding competition in the insurance markets.
We're having new carriers come into the market. Competition brings lower rates and things of that nature. We need around 10 or 12. And there are rumors of another three or four that will enter the market by the end of the third quarter.
So what I'm hearing is that property insurance markets and rates will continue to stabilize into 2024. After the 2021 Miami Surfside building collapse here in South Florida, the Florida legislature made a decision to pass a bill that required all condos that are three stories or taller when they reach 30 years of age, and then every 10 years after, have inspections that look for substantial deterioration and deficiencies. And that's caused many buildings to have expensive engineering and construction work done. And in Jim Burke's case, these inspections deemed his balconies unsafe.
We signed a contract for $340,000. Unfortunately, the operative word is it's an estimate. So I anticipate there'll be additional costs when they find further damage, if they do, meaning we'll have assessments, which is scary.
And making things even more complicated for condo associations that are deficient on their maintenance. As of December 31st, 2024, Florida condo associations are no longer allowed to waive reserve contributions. This means they must ensure adequate funds are available even if it wasn't there previously. So you can see the three key drivers that are really skyrocketing HOA costs. But the real question is, what are the next 6 months to a year going to look like? There's some good news on the insurance front.
I do believe the worst is behind us. And over the next 24 to 36 months, you will level off to start to come down as carriers enter a better marketplace for insurance.
Many HOAs are getting their finances in good shape. They're doing a better job at predicting assessments and future maintenance requirements, as well as they're collecting money for the projects, and projects are actually getting done. However, there are a number of condo owners in this current marketplace that can no longer afford pay these HOA fees and these large assessments, people that are on fixed income as an example. And we're getting calls on a regular basis from condo owners who are asking us to help them sell their condo for this reason. So the big question you're probably asking is, now the time to buy or sell a condo here in South Florida? To answer the questions, we need to take a look at the key indicators. I've observed a significant increase in condo days on market. Last year, on average, it took about 54 days to sell a condo. Now it's taking 80 days or more. That's a staggering 48% more time to sell a condo. Another data point that's getting relatively concerning in this market is the absorption rate. The way we think about absorption rate is by looking at all the active listings that are on the market and seeing how long it would take to sell or absorb all those listings if the rate of sales continued at a steady pace. Right now, it would take about 9 months to sell all the inventory on the market. Last year at the same time, it would take about 4 months. So we now have more than double the amount of condo inventory on the market. So there's a lot more competition out there. You would think this would drive condo prices way down, but surprisingly, that's not what we're actually seeing in the data.
the average sold price and the median sales price are remaining at about the same as last year. However, condo pricing is a lagging indicator as it reflects sales prices that went under contract a month or two ago. Lately, on the other hand, I am seeing from my own experience, condo prices coming down. Taking all these metrics into account, I do foresee a decrease in condo prices for the upcoming traditionally slower summer selling season. However, the busier fall and winter seasons, they might present a different scenario influenced by fluctuating interest rates and heightened demand for housing. If you're thinking about selling in the next year or so and want to get a little bit more for your condo, I would say get ahead of the market and sell now rather than wait. If you're thinking about buying now or in the near future, the number one rule here is be careful. Make sure you have a realtor who helps you do a meticulous review of the condo documents, assessments, HOA fees, and a careful scrutiny of HOA minutes so you truly know what you are getting into. There may be some decent buys out there right now, but you have to do your homework. Well, I hope all this was helpful. To stay more informed about the evolving condo market landscape here, make sure to hit subscribe. Your support is much appreciated. Please show it also by hitting the like button if you found this video helpful. I'm Larry Mastropieri, broker owner of the Mastropieri Group, and I look forward to connecting with you all on the next video. Welcome to South Florida.